We haven't had the reveal of Breath of the Wild 2, but there's one big question that remains to be answered. Namely, will Princess Zelda be playable in Breath of the Wild 2? And there have been a number of theories going around, most of them focusing around Ganondorf and his role, Celtic, who's joining me right now. But at the end of Breath of the Wild, when it appears that Calamity Ganon, Darkest Ganon have been defeated, Zelda is finally free.
Yep.
Reunited with Link after 100 years.
She gets a little smile moment.
Exactly, you get a little smile moment that and they're heading to Zora's domain.
Yeah.
Some time passes, she has a much shorter hairdo, and the question is why?
So yeah, the big question is whether or not Zelda's playable.
Mm-hmm.
I am in team no on this. As much as I'd love Zelda to be playable, I don't think she is at all. I don't think this trailer is indicative of that. But you're the opposite, aren't you?
Yeah. I would like to hear your opinion first, though. Why she isn't playable.
So there's obviously a few things that lend itself to the possibility that we will get a playable Zelda, such as the shorter hairdo.
Mm-hmm.
Shows a change in her character. Was that some in Japanese culture, it shows a change in someone's life. And people think this is her moving from her kind of regal responsibilities.
Yeah, because the Kingdom of Hyrule is pretty much a smoked ruin.
Basically. So she's moving on from that. And also people think it's easier because it won't clip into her shield if she has a shield. If she's playable.
Yeah, if she's playable.
I just think this is a cutscene. Like, I think that's all this is.
But it seems that Zelda might have a much more active role because she was just in cutscenes.
For sure.
And in Breath of the Wild, but this time it seems like she might be there next to you. So if not playable, she would at least maybe be following you or having an active role. But this wouldn't work throughout the entire game. That's obvious.
Because there are things in the trailer that would make me think it would be very, very cool if Zelda was playable. For example, there's Link and Zelda traveling through these caves and they've got this pack animal with them. Mm-hmm. And on the back of this pack animal, there's loads of firewood, there's an axe, there's all these camping supplies. And I just think it would be so cool if you could traverse across Hyrule and have to set up camp and have to kind of maintain your supplies with this pack animal.
Or solve puzzles.
But unfortunately, I do think this is just cutscenes.
Yeah.
I don't think this is indicative of gameplay, as cool as that would be.
So you don't think that we'll play as her, just as Link?
I don't, but I would love to be proven wrong on that. I'd love it to be the other way around because it would work quite well if it was similar to Ciri in The Witcher 3, so she was obviously the main character is Geralt, but then you get small sections where you get to play as Ciri for maybe 15-20 minutes.
Yeah, like say at some point Link and Zelda split.
Yeah.
And then you play some sections as Link and the other one as Zelda.
Yeah, exactly.
That could be a possibility. Like many have been pointing out in favor, because I'm in part, like a few others also believe that she will be playable. They wouldn't be putting so much emphasis on her in this trailer.
This is a very Zelda trailer rather than Link trailer.
It is a very Zelda heavy trailer, and we see who is confronting Ganondorf in this trailer. It's Zelda. Yes, it's a clear callback, as Twitter pointed out. Awoken, or resurrected,
is like the turn in
that is the turn in Ocarina of Time when Ganondorf is revealed for the first time inside Hyrule Castle, kneeling in front of the King of Hyrule.
Yeah,
and I have a feeling that Zelda could be playable in that sense that she's wielding a number of items here.
Yeah,
we see that she's holding a torch and so on. And we also know that Link doesn't have the Sheikah Slate anymore.
No.
So that will change gameplay drastically, which means that you won't have the access to the runes anymore. And what if Zelda has the Sheikah Slate? That is the question.
Because then she used it 100 years ago to for like her research and everything.
That would make sense for her then to be playable, because then she could use them in her sections while Link would have to deal with other stuff.
Yeah. It would work well from a story perspective, because most Zelda games, the main conflict is Link and Ganon, Link and Demise, Link and whoever. But this Zelda and Calamity Ganon they're much more closely related than Link is to
Ganon. It's very personal. They've fought for 100 years.
Yeah, exactly.
Inside the Hyrule Castle Sanctum.
It was her kingdom that she felt she failed when she couldn't awaken her powers. She had that breakdown in the forest. Zelda's like quite closely tied to Ganon in this game, more than usual.
Yeah, first that she wasn't able to unleash her power in time before he returned.
Yes.
And then when she finally ended up confronting...
Both times where there was a proper, like, climactic conflict, it was, in Breath of the Wild, it was Zelda to kind of come to the rescue.
Yeah.
Like, with the Guardian, the climax of the Guardian battle at Fort Hateno and Dark Beast Ganon, both times. It's Zelda and
that's also another argument in favor of her being playable, that it's her quest.
Mm.
Because Link doesn't have much more of a quest anymore. His quest was pretty much to save Princess Zelda and destroy Ganon. Mm. Yes, in this case Ganon may be back, but it looks like it's Zelda's task to finish what she wasn't able to end in twice.
Thematically it does make sense. I would like it to happen, I just don't think they're going to take that step.
But it has been discussed already, and I know Anuma has been playing around the idea. And he wants this to be a very different Zelda.
Yeah.
So, if you want to make it different, then you would make Princess Zelda playable, because if you have the same Hyrule, you want to experience this Hyrule differently, because if you're not able to discover new locations, obviously there will be new areas, but if we talk about the existing ones, then you want at least to have a different experience when you meet NPCs, when you go into settlements and so on. And that is something you would get from Princess Zelda.
Exactly.
Compared to Link. We know exactly how people respond to Link.
Yeah. But people thought the same about Breath of the Wild, though. They thought it's kind of a clean slate for the Zelda series, basically. Mm-hmm. And then the first trailer, people were like, that might not be Link. That looks kind of like a woman. And then Aonuma was like, I didn't say that was Link. And everyone got really excited. And then, yeah, it's Link. I don't know, he likes to play around, I think, with people in that regard.
But this, in this case, they just changed so much with Zelda.
Like, yeah,
it's obvious that she
is... It's definitely a more story-driven game, if this is anything to go by.
Exactly.
Anything to go by.
And, like, we don't know what happens with Link when he is attached.
That's
by
the
this.
New gameplay mechanic. That
exactly.
Is,
it's
sure
it's a new gameplay mechanic. Yeah. But I would also explain that, okay, Link has this power, so maybe he needs Zelda for his support to some extent. It's pretty much 50-50, because... In this case, they push Zelda much, much more than they ever did in Breath of the Wild.
Yeah.
Like, for one, she wasn't even in most of the trailers.
No, she's only in cutscenes.
Yeah, like, right. we saw her for the first time in the Nintendo Switch presentation trailer.
But then what if this is all the cutscenes at the start of the game? She gets trapped by Ganondorf and then that's it.
I have a better theory. Link gets trapped.
That would be cool.
Because that seal.
Because there's something
could
going
seal
on.
Him.
Yeah, that would be cool.
And then Zelda, it's up to Zelda to one find a way to free Link, and pretty much the opposite thing that happened in Breath of the Wild. And that would be, for one, it's dark. Yeah, Link is now locked again.
Yeah.
Ganon is out, and now it's Zelda's turn to mend things.
Hmm.
To bring them back. So there's just so many possibilities, and you can speculate about absolutely everything in this.
As we all know, the reveal trailer for the Breath of the Wild sequel gave a heavy sense of co-op, a continuation in many ways of what we saw in the cutscenes from 100 years prior in Breath of the Wild, when Link and Zelda eventually over time grew fond of each other and worked together. So this theme might be continued in The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild 2, or whatever the name will be. But in this case, maybe you will be able to play as both characters, or at least cooperate as Link with Zelda. And when it comes to Zelda, it's that she has been more and more playable in spin-off games, because even though Zelda has never been playable in a mainline Zelda game, she, besides her inclusion in Super Smash Bros. And where in Ultimate she took center stage, she's also been playable, and in the case of Breath of the Wild Zelda, in Hyrule Warriors Definitive Edition, and Cadence of Hyrule, that being a Link Between Worlds Zelda. So, could it finally be time to have a playable Zelda in a mainline Zelda game? Maybe not as the main protagonist, but as a substitute or an alternative. Switching between Link and Zelda could work, like swap between the two by the press of a button, or you could play as them in specific sections when they split, separate, or when they play together in specific scenarios. And this could actually work much more simpler than you may think. And that is because the Breath of the Wild AI, both for civilians and monsters, that will say NPCs, was deeply sophisticated. Zelda for sure has horse riding and combat experience, and is lighter than Link. But what if she will have a different role? Say that she's using the Sheikah Slate to aid Link in battle, and so on. There are just so many possibilities. And as we all know, this Zelda game is going to be different. And the experience in that could also be different by having swapping characters. Similarly to what is the case in the Final Fantasy VII remake, where each character has its own attributes. So just like in Final Fantasy VII, a co-op Zelda could actually work in Breath of the Wild 2. And the way it could work is that Link, as we have seen already both on the thumbnail of the reveal trailer on YouTube and in the reveal trailer itself, Link is gaining a new power which seems to be based on the ancient Sheikah Zonai tribe. And this power will inflict his right hand. So perhaps this will be Link's power. But what about the Sheikah Slate? Since the Sheikah Slate is not seen at all throughout this reveal trailer, it appears that Zelda actually left it behind since she was the last person to wield it. In the true ending of The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, as they were heading off to Zora's domain. So if both of them make their way out, or if Link is sealed, it is very likely that Zelda will probably start using the Sheikah Slate again, all its capabilities. Naturally, it will depend if they will stay in Hyrule or not. But it looks like Zelda and Link could offer drastically different gameplay, and that Link even will play differently than he did in Breath of the Wild. Which is a very big deal, since if Zelda will have the powers of Link, that will say the Sheikah Slate from Breath of the Wild, and Link will have a brand new power that will make him play completely differently, then a combination of the two may be exactly what is needed to take down Ganondorf.
I think a playable Zelda in the style of Ciri from The Witcher 3 would be so cool, like if you could play as her for certain sections of the game, but I think I'm in a minority in that I wouldn't want the option to play as Zelda for a large part of the game, or even the whole game, especially not in place of Link. One thing I love about Zelda, and Breath of the Wild especially, is that you really feel like the hero. You get new items, you get new abilities, you're constantly improving and surviving in the wild, and the immersion of Breath of the Wild is one of the best things about the games, mainly because you're just this one character, lost in the wilderness, and you experience everything alongside Link. If you switch to another character, it would kind of take away from this for me a little bit. I'd love playable Zelda sections, but for the most part, I'd want to stick to Link.
This is such a small snippet of what is probably going to be a very story-driven, quite a long story-driven game.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, at least I hope so.
Yeah, it's for sure going to be more linear.
Yeah, you can predict which way the story will go from this one snip, but snippet of the story, but the chances of you being right are so slim, just because we don't know what's going to happen. We don't know anything. We know they're in a cave.
We know that's what we know.
There's Ganondorf thing, and he wakes up, and that's it. We don't know anything.
Yeah, and we also know that the team has worked very hard on improving the visuals compared to Breath of the Wild.
Yeah, it looks
like they want to one up.
It's the same engine. You can tell
it's the same engine, but they've added more particles, made the water behave more realistically.
Right, like refraction.
Yeah, the same goes with how the shadows are cast for different characters. Like things you usually wouldn't notice, but which they are obsessed with, because they want to create a world that is as believable as possible. Exactly, and I have a feeling that they want to make a number of changes so that even though we are playing in the same Hyrule, it's going to be a completely different game experience.
Mm.
And one way to do that is to play as Zelda.
Yeah, it would make sense. Right?
Because we need to remember, all these games we've not been able to play like Zelda, and it has to be a first for everything.
That's true, yeah.
And we have played a full adventure now with Link. Maybe it will just be like in Metal Gear, you know, Metal Gear Solid 2.
I don't know.
Yeah, we start as the character from Metal Gear Solid 1, and then you go over to play as the other character.
Oh, right.
And in this case, it's been teased that Zelda is kind of much more active here. I mean, she wears her adventure gear. She has got
short hair,
so it's no obstacle anymore to both have a shield, a sword, bows, or any kind of weaponry that would have otherwise gotten in the way. And we can also see her wielding items.
That's true, yeah, the torch. Again,
that's hints.
Occam's Razor says it is it's cutscene footage.
Exactly.
I would love it if you could.
So, like, if we sum this up quickly.
Yeah.
There's the possibility that you play together mm-hmm. and then you may switch between characters. That would be actually very cool. Option.
That would, yeah.
Because then, like, then
say, you go one way in a cave, one character goes one way and at the end.
Yeah, and say that Zelda has some abilities, Link has some abilities, and together they are able to.
Yeah, like you said, if you give Zelda the slate and mm-hmm. her like awakened powers and stuff, and then Link has obviously a sword, and then whatever this green thing is.
It would definitely change the way we approach boss battles.
Yeah.
And also, more challenging mini
bosses. Open the possibility of local co-op.
Absolutely, absolutely. In some scenarios, at least. And the choice is probably the best, because I feel that people will not like to just play as Zelda.
No.
At the same time, people will also be disappointed by just playing as Link. So the best would maybe be have Zelda there, but she's more of a substitute, in a sense.
Yeah,
okay.
So you can that makes sense.
Put her in, and then whenever you need her, you can play as her.
I think it would be cool.
That would be the best option
And I see, there are definitely... The trailer does set it up. If they wanted to go in that direction, they can. Mm-hmm. And the trailer sets it up well.
But what do you think?
Yeah, leave it in the comments, let us know.
Do you really believe that Zelda will be playable in any way, shape or form? Whether it is as the main lead, as a character in certain situation, or as a swappable character between whenever Link is not able to accomplish something. We'd love to hear more about it and maybe even elaborate more on this, because Zelda is definitely going to be much more important in this game.
But she's actually in the game.
She's in the game, she's no longer in cutscenes, and that's a big step. And if you haven't already, then check out Zeltic's channel.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Other than that, a big thank you to all our patrons, Royal Producers Kenelta Ali and Belly Carriage. Other than that, check out all of these two videos of them, and we'll see you in the next one. Alright.
See you in a bit.
Bye.